Oh, hey.
What's that you say? You won't marry me because I'm an angry feminist? Oh, look at how angry I am. Oh, darn. And I would have gone away with it if it weren't for you meddling men. I guess I better learn how to be wifey material.
Hello there, and welcome to today's episode of Why Do Men? No, but really, why do they? So if you're wondering why I've changed, basically, I filmed this whole video and buggered up the audio. So I've had to refilm it, and I'd already returned the costume I hired. So this will have to do for today. But in fairness, I actually think I would get married in this. So today I will be marrying myself. You know, that's the only plot point I remember from Glee. Oh, and a teenage pregnancy. Oh, and all the stuff with He Who Shall Not Be Named. But yes, today's video will be about marriage. Specifically, what makes a woman marriage material, or marriageable, as some of the Manosphere channels say, which I don't think that's actually a word. It doesn't sound right, does it? But then again, nothing about all this discourse is right, which we will get into in a moment. But before we do, let me introduce myself. My name is Tara Mooney, and this is the only channel on YouTube where all videos are written and produced by a cow. She couldn't be in the video today because she actually happens to be at a wedding herself. She's in the bridal party, and I've said to her, cow, don't get with one of the groomsmen. You can do so much better. But when she's had a bit too much tequila, well. But if you like and subscribe, she might appear in the next video. So before we shed our feminist scales and learn how to be marriageable to the men, let's hear a word from today's sponsor. Before we crack on, I'd like to take a moment to thank today's sponsor, Ren. Climate change, the environment. It's all a bit bleak, isn't it? And I don't know about you, but most of the time, I feel powerless about it. The Earth has been and is currently being destroyed by a small number of corporations that only care about making profits. Scary stuff. But something that gives me comfort is that I have the ability to fund projects that will help the environment that corporations refuse to. So at least I can sleep at night, unlike those fossil fuel. So Ren is a website where you can calculate your carbon footprint, then offset it by funding a number of carbon reduction projects, including tree planting, mineral weathering, and rainforest protection. All you need to do is answer a few questions about your lifestyle. You then find out your carbon footprint, and then you offset it by choosing one of Ren's specifically curated projects to donate to. Once you sign up to make a monthly contribution to offset your carbon footprint, you will receive monthly updates from the projects you support. You get to see exactly what your money is spent on, with photos and all. A local project to me is the Mineral Weathering Project in Scotland. So this project entails buying degraded land and restoring it back to health using agroforestry methods. Then they expand the carbon sequestration potential of the forest through a cutting-edge technique called mineral weathering. So it's pretty cool stuff. And it's right on my doorstep. Well, it's like a 7-hour train, but. So if you're looking to join a collective action to help battle climate change, Ren is the place to go for verified carbon reduction projects. And if you're not 100% convinced, go check out their Trustpilot reviews, because they are ace. And Ren have sponsored me a few times now, so I can really vouch for them. Thank you so much for sponsoring today's video, Ren. Now, let's get back to roasting some men. So you want to learn how to be marriage material, eh? I found a snippet from a podcast episode from a channel named Rich Cooper Clips. And he's a guy.
Wow.
That's it, he's a guy. But he's a guy in the general sort of manosphere space. And on Google, it says that he's 92 years old, which doesn't seem right to me. Unless he means in wisdom, because he's not a blue-pilled cuck. So he's written works such as The Unplugged Alpha, The No Bullshit Guide to Winning with Women and Life, And just to read his Twitter bio, unplug from a matrix of comforting lies with cold, hard, and uncomfortable truths on YouTube. So just straight out of the gate, we've already got some fat phobia here. And we've also got some transphobia. I've stopped buying from anyone that has woke commercials. This has boosted my personal finances and my mental well-being. This reminded me of that time when Gillette said men shouldn't be masculine because it was somehow bad.
Was that what happened? I thought the message was just, don't sexually harass women.
I found a clip from one of his podcast episodes where he and a bunch of buddies discuss why women can't get married anymore. It's a bunch of dudes. And yeah, it's a bunch of dudes. Shall we take a look?
What should we kick off on the topic of delusion in 2021? Does anybody want to?
Well, Aaron was on quite an interesting show with some females.
Females?
But in this particular episode, there are three gals. They're all in 30 plus. And I asked them, like, okay, do you want to get married? Where does getting married rank in your priorities today? Mm-hmm. And why aren't you married now? And they were all attractive women. There have been good men that have thrown themselves at their feet. But when you talk to real live women and you realize it isn't shtick, you know, the dating profiles we see, like, oh, is that just the worst of the worst? It's like, no, you start getting a real baseline. You put your finger on the pulse. You're like, this is real. Like, we've been pretty accurate in women's disinterest in men.
I love how he's like, when you speak to actual women.
One guy was like, well, me, my career, my dogs. Dogs. You're freaking dogs.
Oh, this is a personal call out. Oh my God, actually, that reminds me. Yes, the dogs. It is the most cringy when people refer to their dogs as their children. It's an indicator of demoralization and degeneration, courtesy of postmodernism. What in the Jordan Peterson is this? Before The Catcher in the Rye was published, people didn't love their dogs. And a particular moment I found really funny is that another guy just pops in 3 minutes into this 4 minute clip. And his name is Rolo Tomassi. And Rolo, why are you so late? Rolo, you're a time cuck. You got
cucked by time.
And that's why you're late. I don't think that was a very good joke, but I'm going to keep it in because these fellas do not like being called cucks.
Women are surrounded by this tornado of misinformation, really? And no one corrects them because we want to fuck them. Mm-hmm. So they are so far removed because everyone will tell them what they want to hear because either guys want to fuck them or governments want their votes or businesses want their money. Mm-hmm. And there was no getting through to them. No getting. So there was a very good bit of anecdotal evidence as to how disconnected the women of that age are.
And you know what they say? The best kind of evidence is anecdotal evidence. So that was just a little starter, a little warm up. Just, you know, get your palate, you know, ready for the shit that I'm about to show you. Now you might see this clip and think, oh, look, there's a bunch of women. Isn't that great? No, it's not. It's a fucking train wreck.
There are women out there that are marriageable who are of that mindset. You feel me? And that's all I want to say, that, like, you know, for niggas that think that, oh, if you think that marriage is even an option, you're blue pill.
It's just, you know, the thing is that, like, I mean, we
I mean,
had
most of these niggas, they ain't made no married. Fucking money, don't get no fucking pussy. You know what
that.
I'm saying? Like,
that,
it's like, they fall into a cult of red pill. They watch a million videos on YouTube and they think, like, they know shit. Like, you niggas never fuck bitches. You niggas never made no money. Like,
oh my God, this is just absolutely chef's kiss. He is roasting Fresh and Fit to their faces. And he doesn't even realize. Oh God, it's so good.
I'll say all this. Right. But here's the thing. The concern is that a lot of modern day women aren't willing to put marriage and family ahead of their own personal happiness.
Whoa, 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 wait. It's women's fault.
Women. Yeah, not all women want a super submissive woman either. Like, some men don't want, like, don't want to take the whole burden on
them. Like, well, ladies, like, you guys are asking us? Hold on. You guys have three guys. You guys have three guys on the panel here. They're in the top 1% of male earners, etc. And we are literally telling you to your face what men of our caliber want from women that other men will never, ever tell you. Because if I told you to your face as a regular guy with a job, hey, stop being rude, stop being masculine, your career isn't that important, family comes first, I would get hit with the,
how dare you?
Oh, a soundbite from Greta Thunberg where she's talking about the world being destroyed by climate change. Funny.
In the woman's opinion, I don't think she'll turn down the ring. even if she was making all that money and a man came up and proposed to her, I think she'll still take the companionship.
Here's the thing.
Yeah, but she's not going to get that high-valued man.
Damn.
Thank you,
man.
Thank
you.
I'm not saying it's a high-valued.
Beta-ass male. I'm saying
the high value for the show.
You're going to be all right. You're going to be okay. You're going to be okay.
She's going to ask what she wants.
She's going to be all right. She's going to be all right.
I could go for the ad hominem attack and call this person a phrase I don't like using because I think it's gone a bit too far. But if it walks like a duck, if it quacks like a duck, and the duck is screaming pick me,
then it's a pick me duck.
A woman that puts her husband and family first is what makes her extremely attractive. Mm-hmm. So a higher status guy.
Yeah. Before the family. Yo, honestly, okay. some women have tried to be yet we still get left behind. Like, honestly, I've tried to be that girl. I've tried to cook.
But you're not doing,
clean.
You're doing that for a beta male. You're not doing that for a high-valued male. And that's what you need to understand.
Imagine unironically saying beta male.
You're not doing it for the right... You're not doing it for a man.
Somebody watches the podcast a little too often.
Keep watching.
Oh, that was such a roast. It's true, though. My girl is lost in the sauce.
But that's why I asked that question, because I don't know many women that think like me besides like my grandma.
Yeah, there might be a reason for that.
And to say that this show is devaluing women is entirely false. They're putting us on. Like, what are you talking about? They're literally putting
you
on.
But you have, mommy, you just count. No, because there's 11 women, one. They're only supporting you because you support them.
Yeah.
Like, this makes me genuinely sad. No, but they do respect us.
When we completely agree with them.
My personal position is irrelevant. I just go off of the facts.
Oh God, I can't take any more of this. That's it. I'm rage quitting. But anyways, I think that's enough for today. Did I learn how to become marriageable to these men? Kinda. But you know what? It's not worth it. But if that means that I end up with a beta male who values my opinions and wants me to also enjoy sex, then so be it.
It's way more important to protect her than to please her. Who gives a fuck about a woman's orgasm? It's useless.
Right.
But anyways, thank you so much for watching. I'm sorry for putting you through this. But to me, this illustrates that these dudes are clinging on to the idea of locking down a woman into marriage because that's their last kind of grasp of control. But if marriage isn't appealing to women and having a career and independence is, kind of makes these dudes obsolete. And they're not coping well with that fact. But anyways, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like, because one like equals one woman from the Fresh and Fit podcast being freed. No, you know what? I changed my mind. All of you. I'll rescue all of you. Everyone get in the car and we can yeet out of here. Vroom, vroom, like Charlie XCX. Okay, I'll see you all in the next one. Bye-bye. Bye-bye now. Bye-bye. Bye-bye now. Bye-bye. Hey everybody, thank you so much for watching the video today. I thought I'd try something a bit different for this video, where I leave the subscription pet shout out till the end credits, just to accompany the lovely patron credits. So first of all, I just want to thank my gorgeous patrons for supporting the channel and making it possible, especially considering the last video was age restricted. Whoopsie! And as for today's subscription pet shout out, I just want to thank Erin for sending in your beautiful doggy, or sorry, as you said, worm on a string, and I can definitely see the resemblance. So this is Mowgli. He is 3 years old and frankly an idiot, but that's okay because he's pretty. And you are not wrong, look at this gorgeous boy. Thank you, Erin, so much for sending your beautiful son, brother, whatever the relation is there. And if you would like your pet to be featured, send your submissions to subscriptionshoutout@gmail.com. Thanks so much for watching the video and supporting the channel. Lots of love.